So, just thinking on everything that's going on in the country as a black man with a son, a teenage black son, yes, you know, I feel that all of us are affected by what's going on and what's being played out in the media. And just for all the brothers out there who know who they are, who've been in the struggle and understand that, yes, you know, as a black man, we are hunted. We are targeted. It is much, much harder for us to just do the basic survival. It's been recorded in our history since we've been to this in America. You know, we know this, whether it is publicized or known to the degree we want it to be, that's whatever. But so we are affected by this. And I mean, most of y'all who follow me on Facebook know that I'm very, you know, I'm very adamant about awareness of this and is understanding it a little bit more deeper than what it is, you know, because we really are not giving our, we're not having forums about, I mean, we maybe are, I'm not sure. Facebook is a good forum and I'm definitely engaging in some great conversations. So that's good. However, I think something, I think that, well, the media taints it all, so we're not even getting the actual facts. But then again, people, brothers, we don't need to know the actual facts in the story. We see the video, and we all can relate to that. It's, we have all been on the block, and police jump out, run up, get you, boom, you know. Hey, that's just a part of our life. So now that it's being played on the media, we're like, yep, yep, know what that is, all day. So I pose a question, and, you know, to this, all the militant brothers out there that are ready for action, has been in the struggle, and we know that, you know, we know this, what the system, what it is, you know, big support to Anonymous Movement. That is definitely a vanguard in the social network and just getting the message out there with facts and being effective. Keyword, effective. How do we become effective? I think that, and this is just me putting this out there, I want you all to weigh in. I want the conversation. I like I said earlier, I want to have the conversation, you know, because this can go anyway. You know, it can keep perpetuating. The police clearly have an agenda and they're getting their orders. They've been prepped for this. We've saw this when they were doing riot trainings and fallout trainings. I mean, this is all known. So we have, as black men, as black people, first, I think we need to pose the question of nationalism, black independence. Do we need a black nation? Do the African-American, Caribbean, all Africans that were brought to the Western Hemisphere through slavery and the slave trade that has been displaced from their motherland, and we see the effects of that being put in the lowest class, first going through slavery, being a part of a system which is based on racism and classism. You know, there is an elite class that runs the world and they are dominating and they're using the police force to enforce their rule. We know that. So there's the choice of living as a slave or having the choice of being free, being an independent, free nation. You know, of course, when a groups of people pose this and want this, there are these elements. There is a strong sense of pride and loyalty in that people. Black people, we don't have that as much. There is, it exists. However, if it was stronger, if it was more embraced, then I think we would have a good argument. So maybe there needs to be a little bit more black love. I'm not sure. Again, I pose the question, what are some of the solutions? And we all are rallying for and we're marching for, you know, we want change in legislation. We want tougher. I mean, but essentially, you're putting a Band-Aid on a sore that's not going to heal that way. Like, the root of the problem is the system that's in place. You know, these police force all over the nation and all of, I mean, they're getting all of this, all of the weaponry and defense that we use in the Middle East and Afghanistan and Iraq. They're getting all that surplus. That's military grade. They knew they were going to get that. So like, oh, we got any land around here. Take it. They knew they were going to get it because the next phase is controlling the people of America. They're realizing that, huh, maybe they're too free. Because it's a sense of control. It's control. You own the law. You mean to tell me cops, y'all can't talk? You don't want to talk to us. You know, that's not your plan. You're not playing. You're not here. We feel in the black community that your goal with us is not to serve and protect. You're not serving us. You're not doing us a service. I ain't never seen a cop pull up to me when I had a flat tire and say, hey, buddy, you need a hand? I mean, if he pulled up, he was like, what's the problem here? Like, I mean, what the fuck? I'm trying to change the tire. You know, let me see your eye. Let me run you through this. You know, I mean, so that, come on. That's blatant. Whether you want to admit that or not, if you can't admit that, then that means we can have a conversation of resolution. If you don't want to admit that, then that's saying, okay, you don't give a fuck. And then that goes, as the people, what do we do? What do we do? A lot of questions. I want the conversation to happen with all of us. Let's build a forum. We need leaders now. You know, Malcolm is not here. Huey and Bobby, they're not here. We need to understand that, is it Black Nation time now? And if so, let's propose it to the system and see what they say. Because we have a valid motherfucking case. You know, I relate very much to the Palestinians. Wow. It's just in an opposite way. You know, they didn't come in our land and run it. They took us from our land to run their shit. That's real. Understand your history. As black people, understand our histories. We came from slavery and never got any type of reparation or entitlement, never claimed. That's like the Hebrews never leaving Egypt. That's like if Moses said, let my people go, but we're just not going, you know, if they never got let go. You know, we never had our exodus from slavery, from bondage. And we're being treated as that. There's no respect for the black man. None at all. What? Y'all niggas know. Excuse me. Y'all brothers know. Y'all know what's up. And they see what's up. So I pose the question, is it nation time? Please respond. Let me know what's up. Thank you.